Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about what to expect from a Power BI resource having 8 plus years of experience. He can be categorized as architect or consultant based on the roles the candidate is going to play. And this video is not only for the job seekers, and it is also for the hiring managers or interviewers. What to expect from a candidate having 8 plus years of experience? What are the skills you need to assess? That is what we are going to see in this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button to learn the concepts in Power BI and anything related to data analytics. Let's begin with this video. So what are the key skills a person with 8 plus years should possess? It's like he is going to play a role of consultant or architect. So basically going to get the requirement from the client, and it has to be delivered to the, it has to be converted into a technical documents or some kind of documentation work, right? And based on the organization, whether the consultant or architect will be involved in development, or it purely depends upon the organization. Most of the people in this role not involved in the development activities. So what are the key skills specific to this particular role? Let's try to see one by one. He is able to do the software requirement document and the design documents, as this particular role is going to face the clients. He should be having good communication. What are the skills required to face the client? He should be possess. That is most of the key skills that the particular person should have, or the candidate going to have. Also, he should be in a position to have the licensing cost. He is the one who represents the entire architecture of your project. And if it is a new project, most of the architect or consultant role will involved in building a new system, right? If the organization won't be having the data warehousing or the reporting environment. So they should be in a position to suggest the different server-side architectures and the costing, so that it will benefit the company. So costing-wise, this should be aware of. The complete business intelligence implementation. You may be wondering, like the Power BI itself, 6 years back, it got introduced 2015. And how come a person will be having 8 plus years of experience in Power BI? So Power BI is not only meant for reporting. I mean to say, like even you say a Power BI resource with 8 plus years, a person should not have only knowledge on Power BI. He should be having a knowledge on business intelligence. So as most of the organizations will use the full stack BI platform, and then on top of that, Power BI will be used for reporting. This is the flow they will follow. So as a senior resource or a consultant, the candidate should have a knowledge on business intelligent implementation. What are the different cycles, architecture of data warehousing, everything together. And as the world is moving towards Azure, he should also have a knowledge on Azure. Either he is involved in migrating the on-premise to Azure or worked on Azure technologies. So these are the key unique things you should look for with the person having 8 plus years experience and can be categorized as consultant or architect. Other skills, like technical skills, are very good to have, like knowledge on SQL, data warehousing, business intelligence, SSAs, Power BI architectures, Nags knowledge, modeling, and to have Azure, as we see in our previous slide. So why all these skills are good to have, or I should have a better understanding, means as he is going to get the requirement from the client, and based on the understanding or the knowledge he has, like, he should be able to suggest this can be implemented in data warehouse, and this doesn't require the data warehouse. We can directly create the Power BI reports from the source. But when it involves a complex project modeling, it requires a data warehouse in place. So it has to be done using an ETL tool, and then building the data warehouse. Whether the cubes or SSAS modeling is required or not, or from the data warehouse he can process the Power BI. So these kind of suggestions are based on this knowledge. He has to document it and give it to the technical lead or technical team. So unless a person having this knowledge, he cannot be able to do a better documentation. That is the point I want to make. And it purely depends. Let us try to discuss the two category of people, and based on that you can assess in my last slide. Let's continue with what are the things, other things. As I said before, why I mentioned the BI architecture, a person with 8+ years should know, is like, this is the typical BI architecture any organizations will follow. The Power BI plays a major role, but it is the end point of your output. All other process will follow, like you need to collect the data, and most of the organizations use a data warehouse. For that they use SQL. Storing the data will be stored in database. For that you should know SQL. Because while designing the document, you are just not designing the documents like this is the fact and this is the dimension star schema. You also should have a knowledge on the data types. What kind of data types should be used so that the system will be more effective. So in-depth knowledge on the different technologies will give a better architecture of your these projects. That is the point I want to make. So having a knowledge on Azure is mandatory, like all the organizations or most of them are moving towards Azure. So without a knowledge on Azure, you may encounter like you need to upskill it, because you cannot have an architect for on-premise and architect for Azure. So a single person can able to handle it. So if you have a resource with all this knowledge, it will be better for your organization. With specific to the Power BI, what are the skills the person should possess? So these skills, as we already seen in our previous videos, like who is having 5 to 8 years experience. So these skills are very good if the person is having 8+ years as a consultant or architect, where you should have Power Query knowledge, modeling, relationship, and understanding about how it stores. Basically, this person should have a licensing cost and the different features so that he can suggest the business. We can go for pro or premium based on the organization's requirement. And he should also aware of Power BI paginated reports, embedded, and licensing cost. Why these things are required is like, if there is a requirement from the client, he require this kind of reports, this is my expected output. If he not aware of paginated reports, or he only knows Power BI, something cannot be achieved in Power BI, and it can be achieved in Power BI reports, I mean paginated reports. So if the consultant is not aware of, he can say like it is not doable. That is not the right way to give a false information, right? The consultant is giving a false information to his client. So we should possess all the knowledge so that he can able to play a very critical role in suggesting or designing the documents. Let us see other skills. As we see, these are the different Azure skills he should have as a consultant in the business intelligence world or Power BI. In a nutshell, or in a summary, What are the key skills he should possess? Is like SRS, like software requirements, specifications, design documents. He should know licensing, estimation. So this is the major skill a consultant should possess apart from the technical people. Since he should, based on these documents only, the development is going to progress. So this is the main skill. And the skills that I have highlighted in red is like, these are the skills a consultant can optionally known for. Like whether he, or what I'm trying to say is, he may or may not work on these technologies as a hands-on, but he should be good enough to handle or know the concepts behind the databases, data types, and different ETL tools. Also, whether the SSIS cubes or not. So, there are two roles. As I said before, I'm going to say two kind of roles the people will going to act. One is architect. Architect may not involve in designing or development phase. A consultant plays a major role here. He can play a dual role. He will get the requirement from the client. He can document it. And based on the different organization, he may or may not involved in development phase. Some people will give all the documents to the technical people. So they will develop and they will validate and then deliver it to the business. This is one flow. And some in organization, each and everything a consultant will do. He will gather the requirement, he will document it, and along with the technical people, he will develop the things as well. So it is purely based on that. So if he is an architect, these are optional, no hands-on experience required, but he is a consultant and needs to develop the report. These skills also mandatory, whatever I mentioned. This is in nutshell, people should aware of, and specific to Power BI, he should also have a knowledge on Power BI reports, embedding, licensing, other things. So if you want, you can take a screenshot. This is the skills and Power BI resource, or I can say a BI resource having 8+ years should possess. And most of the skills set, it is available in our playlist. Just go and watch it. If you're not having knowledge on SQL or ETL tools and SSIS knowledge or any DAX knowledge, everything is available in our playlist. Just go and have a look at it. You will gain it easily. If you like this video, hit the like button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.